The Elegoo Mars 5. Let's give it a review. Biff, pow, zap, clunk, clunk, ouchie. Hey guys, in the interest of full transparency, I reviewed the Mars 5 Ultra a few weeks ago, and at that time I made brief comments about the standard Mars 5, wherein I accused it of being a step backwards. Well, Elegoo have kindly sent me one of these printers to review, and I was expecting to hate it. But it's hard to dislike something that looks this good. Pretty much everything about the standard Mars is the same as the 5 Ultra in terms of appearance, but for me, I think it looks nicer in green. The 5 is a little smaller than the Ultra, and this obviously has an impact on the build volume. But for a compact machine like this, it's about typical. With that said, it does seem to stand a little taller thanks to these adjustable feet. It has a removable lid, but being a little squarer than earlier generations of Mars, this means we can fit things inside the enclosure, like this CHITU Systems heater. Though of course Elegoo do sell their own enclosure heater. The rear of the lid also has an access port for optional external ventilation, like with the Mars Mate. The power socket, switch and USB port are all found on the right hand side of this printer. The menu screen is in a portrait aspect, and whilst I found this worked fine with the Ultra, I did also find it a little fiddly, especially with the very small keyboard. However, as the standard 5 has no Wi-Fi options, there's no fiddly keyboard, and so the whole portrait aspect works very well. It's a nice, clear, easy to use interface. The resin tray is typically metal and comes with a clear liner. Small studs make plate alignment simple, and it's clamped into place with removable bolts. The build plate may look a little strange unless you're familiar with Elegoo's self-leveling technology. Obviously, there's the laser engraved surface to help print adhesion, but unlike previous generations of Mars, there's no need to manually level the plate with Allen keys and bits of paper. Instead, the plate automatically levels itself for you, removing what is probably the biggest obstacle for newcomers to resin printing. And it really seems to work. The plate clamps to the Z-arm easily with this simple lever, and it's held nice and firmly in place. The 5 Ultra has a very interesting plate tilting mechanism that helps peel the prints from the FEP liner, reducing print failures and increasing performance apparently. However, that feature is not included in the standard Mars 5. Nevertheless, thanks to this funky plate design, as well as self-leveling, it does check the resin level, look for unwanted residue in the tray, and also operate a few alarms with these features in mind. We can see some of this in operation here. The plate is descending into the resin. It slows down, feeling for the resin level. And when it finds it, it hurries along to crack on with the plate leveling. As I've said, it really does seem to work well, all thanks to the smart sensor embedded in the Z-arm, which, by the way, moves typically smoothly. And if we're believing in all this smart technology, the printer goes through a self-diagnostic routine whenever it's turned on. Now all this sounds fine, but the reason I pronounced the Mars 5 to be a step backwards was because of the screen. This 6.6-inch unit is only 4K, and frankly, I'm truly surprised by that. We've already seen 9K screens since the Mars 4 printers, and the Mars 5 Ultra has this same magnificent unit that produces an astonishing 18 microns of XY resolution. However, the standard Mars 5 has a 4K screen with only 35 microns of XY resolution, something we've seen since the Mars 3, I believe. So I just couldn't understand why Elegoo haven't fitted the 9K screen into this printer. It made no sense to me at all. Nevertheless, the proof of performance comes in the print results, I guess. We have seen improvements in the light source design since the Mars 3s, so let's see what this printer can do. To keep the playing field as level as possible, I fitted my CHITU systems heater inside the enclosure and set the temperature for 30 degrees Celsius. I appreciate that Elegoo are taking the stance that heaters are an optional extra, and I appreciate some climates are warmer than others, but let me offer my input on this matter for you. 30 degrees Celsius is a nice, comfortable temperature for most resins. It makes them much more fluid, and that improves print results. So unless you can be certain that your resin will remain at 30 degrees or above, especially given the temperatures drop significantly at night, and of course with changing seasons, then I would highly recommend a heater. Now I should point out that the Mars 5 does actually monitor the temperature of the resin, but this is nothing to do with any heating system. Instead, it's a safety feature to prevent overheating. Sunlu very generously sent me this bottle of red wax resin to try. They seem to think it will impress me, so I thought I'd give it a go here. The Mars 5 is not restricted to any particular slicer, so here I use lychee, and these are the settings that I came up with for all the prints that follow. I started with the tiny Amerilab 10 test print as usual, and, well, I'm genuinely impressed. I really think this is a nice crisp print. I guess because it's a 4K screen rather than the 9K screen we see on the Ultra, I was expecting much worse. But as we go through these prints here, I think you'll see why I've been truly impressed. If for a moment we compare this print with one from the Mars 3 Pro, which has exactly the same specs, I actually think I'd give the edge to the Mars 5. Sure, it might be the colour, it might be the Sunlu resin, which I really like, by the way. Or it could be a better focused photograph. But personally, I just think it's a better print. Obviously, the standard 5 isn't as good as the 5 Ultra. That is altogether much smoother. There's clearly better definition there, thanks to the 9K 18 micron screen. Even with this great print by Archville and Games, I still love the print quality. So, what do I think of the Elegoo Mars 5? Well, despite my initial feelings, I actually really like this printer. I hated the idea that Elegoo had placed a 4K screen where a 9K screen would have done a better job, but we need to understand why this has been done. By sticking with a 4K screen, Elegoo have kept the cost of this unit down, challenging the printer that I had previously picked as my personal favourite budget printer, the Anycubic Mono 2. That has the same spec, and with sale promotions, both Elegoo and the Anycubic are of a similar price. Now, budget printers are for newcomers to the hobby or for those looking for an affordable extra printer, but mainly for newbies, I think. And haven't Elegoo been clever here? The Mars 5 has a wonderful self-leveling plate, and that's going to make life so much better for newcomers. Okay, it's also got self-diagnostics, overheating protection, resin level and resin residue detection as well. But I think it's ease of use that they're cleverly selling here. And that just might steal the edge off Anycubic. After all, the Mars 5 has got a lot going for it. It looks good, it prints great, it's easy to use, and it's affordable. If prices remain keen, Elegoo may well snag more newcomers than they've ever snagged before. And if the experience of these customers is as positive as mine has been, then Elegoo really are onto a winner with the Mars 5. And that's it for this video, guys. As always, please like and subscribe. And just as importantly, feel free to leave any comments or questions below this video. So take care, guys, and thanks for watching.